earlier. Right, I'm gonna do, this is gonna be a short session for those that are kind of trying to fit in shorter sessions. So, right, I'm gonna get started. Again, I'm gonna start off my mat because my mat rolls up. So, from there, if you kind of have your feet together, and then from there, heels out, toes to 12. Taking the body weight back and forwards, onto the front and the backs of your feet. Take them down, insides and outsides, just to get a more stable stance here. Take it to the middle. From there, you're going to just keep your knees soft. Pelvis is going to come back and forwards. So you're going to tuck it in, tip it away. And then one more reach, get your middle point, keep it there. From there, shoulders roll back and down. Just releasing any tension you might have at your shoulders, top of your back. And one more, take it round. Slide the hands down. Right, hands at your ribs, taking a deep breath into your hands, deep breath in through the nose and out through the mouth. And again, deep breath in and out. One more, deep breath in. Right, core. So pulling in your core to your temples. I want you to really pull this bit in as tight as you can. So imagine you've got a belt on, hollow back, 10th hole, hold it there. Release. Take it back, 5th hole, half of that, hold it there. Release. Right, take it back, 2nd, 3rd hole, just a little bit back, hold it there. Release. Right, from there, taking the arms out by the sides. Lengthen up at the top and then release down. Same again, take the arms out by the sides, lengthen up and take it down. And then this time, take it up, lengthen up, and then you're going to take it over to one side and then use your hip to take it back in, other side. Take it over. I'm going to do it again, take your hip in, other side. Other side, lengthen out a bit more from the arms. Hips coming back in, other side. Take it over, lengthen, hips bringing you back in. Right, I'm going to come up my mat, I'm going to bash my wall. Right, take the arms up to the front. You're going to take one arm that's going to come to the back. And you're going to lengthen your arms away. Your eye gaze is going to go over to your back arm. Lengthen them over. Take that back arm back to front and then the other arm to the back. Lengthen away as much as you can. Take that back arm back to the front. Right, we're gonna make a circle. So I'm just gonna show you from this way so I can see. Bring it round, circle round, back to the front. And again, big circle and back. And do this from seated sometimes as well. Big circle, open the chest, back to the front. Reverse, take it round, back to the front. And again, bring it round, back to the front. One more, bring it round. Eye gaze is staying at the finger. Same again, other side. Bring it round, big circle round, to the front. And again, big circle round, really lengthening out the arm. Front and again, last time for this direction. Front, reverse, take it round. And front, two more, take it round. And front, one more, take it round. And front, round. Right, we're just going to get started then, so we're going to come down. So, I'm just going to shuffle my mat out. We're going to roll down, doing a couple of different ones. So it can get warmed up through the spine and then we'll get started. So from there, we're gonna just do one normal one when we come down, come up. So tuck your chin in, slowly building down, one vertebrae at a time. Just sinking down. Just allow everything to just hang down. And we're gonna build back up, so build it back up. One vertebrae at a time. Just making sure that your head is elastic to come up. head's the last thing to come up. Real hands are going behind the head, and we're gonna start by you're gonna let your head come in your hands and just walk back. So you extend in the back, pushing the head into the hand, and then you're gonna start to come back up, and you're gonna just get a nice stretch at your neck, back your neck. So you're gonna again push the head into the hands and start to come down. So roll it down. Start to get in through the spine until you're at the bottom, and then just release the hands. So a little roll through the shoulders, let yourself sink down. Hands back behind the head to come back up. So one vertebrae at a time to build it back up. Again, getting a nice stretch at the neck. And then back up to neutral. And just release the hands. Right, I'm gonna try this. I'm not gonna say that I'm gonna be successful, but I'm gonna attempt it. So you might, if you can do it, go for it. You're gonna cross the legs over. I'm probably gonna squash down it. I've tried it, but I'm not brilliant at it. And you're gonna literally arms forwards or cross or just whichever. And you're gonna sink down. Did you go what you bum? I kind of did it. Right, we're gonna start here. So, start seated. Feet, just kind of shoulder width. And then from there, hands behind. And we're gonna just start coming, rolling back. And then I've got a habit of doing this with my arms, so I'm gonna just correct myself. And then again, pulling in yourself, coming back up. And again, just round. In to come back up. Two more of those. Round to come back. Taking it back up. One more. Take it down. And take it up. Brown. Right, we're going to go into saw. So I'm going to come this way because I'm going to end up bashing my wall. So you can either have the legs kind of just where your mat is, or if you want to go a bit further out, you can do. So lengthen up, take the arms out by each side. You're going to take your arms across, and you're going to take them across to the other leg. So you're going to saw, imagine you're sawing off the pinky, that's why it's called saw. Take it back in, across to the other side, and back in. I'm going to shut one more time. Again, crossing it over the wall. I'm gonna bash the wall with my hand. Take it back in. Cross. Take it down. Again, as you're coming across, just making sure that you, so if I'm coming this side to this side, I don't want this sit bone coming up. I want it to stay down. Take it back in. Other side. Right, we'll just make it a little bit smoother, a little bit quicker. Not too quick. So just let your breath flow with it. Breathe in as you come across. Breathe out as you're coming down. Right, one more for each side. And take it back to the middle. Right, from there, if you come down onto your back. So just again, try to articulate through your spine, so we come down. And then lengthening out. From there, I'm going to combine two moves. So I'm going to start with one, start with the other, and then combine them. So hands by your side to start with. Pelvic curl. Slowly take it up. I'm only going to do a few because I'm going to do more pelvic up. Curl it up. Make sure your knees are not flaring out. Make sure you're not coming up too high. And make sure you're not too down too low. Right, one more. Take it up. Take it down. Right, keep the, stay exactly where you are. All you're gonna do is move your hands behind your head, one with your chest lift. So take it up, slowly down. We're just going to do two more. And one more. Right, from there, just keep your hands behind your head. From there, you're going to curl up. Again, not too high because your hands are behind, so curl up slowly down. And then add a curl in. Slowly down, curl it back up. And I cheated there, I missed a part of my spine, so I'm going to just make sure I do that proper next time. Curl up, take it down, one vertebrae at a time, so curling up. And down. And curl. Down. Last time. Curl back. Back down. And chest lift. And back down. Well, from there, come on your side. So just shuffle, roll on your side. Right. From there, we're going to bring the top leg. So you're going to tuck it in. So just have your head down. Top leg. Gonna brush it, tuck it in, take it up, control down. Again, you can either keep your hand down or you can take the arm up if you want to make it harder. Right, just do one more this way. And then go the other way. So you're gonna go up with the leg, tuck it in. Tap the toe to the inside of the leg, straighten it out. Two more. Take it up, tuck it in, tap, straighten out. One more. Take it up, tuck it in, straighten it out. Well, right, we're going to come onto our back again. Doing the same leg, using the same leg we've just moved. So roll back onto your back. And then from there, you can either keep the other leg bent or straighten it. And then have it, if you're gonna have it straight, have a little bit on an angle, so that's gonna help your movement and stop your pelvis wobbling. So take the leg up, you're gonna circle round, take it back to where it was. Circle round, take it back to where it was. Keeping it a circle as much as you can. One more. Other direction, circle round, back. Circle round, back. Two more. I think I've mucked that up, but never mind. And take it in. Right, we're going to go to this side. So I'm just going to flip to this side. So you're going to see the back side of us. Right, so same again. Just what we're doing on the other side. So the top leg is coming in, taking it up, lengthening down. And again, if you want to make it harder, the top arm will just come up. Tuck it in, take it up, lengthen away. Right, one more this way. Take it in, and take it down again, reversing. So you're going to go up straight, tuck it in, toe to the inside the leg, pushing it away. That's one, two more. Take it up, tap, take it away, and one more. Tuck, straighten away. And we're going to come onto our back again. Roll out your back again. And we're going to do the other leg. So again, if you're going to have that other leg straight, you have a bent, or if you want it straight, have a bit on an angle on your mat. So you're going to stop your pelvis from wobbling. And then the other leg is going straight, hands out a little bit. Circle round, back in. Circle round, back in. Again, using your breath. Help you. Right, two more. And other way. This is my crunchy hip side. Lovely. Two more. One more. And just tuck both legs in. Little rock side to side. And and you're going to roll onto your front. So roll onto your front, and if you come off the mat, you come off your mat, shuffle onto your front, and then from there, if you come to your forearms, and then from there, you're going to, we're going to do single leg kick, so into a double leg kick. So if you lift up the stomach just a little bit, lift up the legs, and we're going to kick through the legs and point the toes. So keeping your body up, kick, 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 kick. So you really should be getting those legs, the muscles switched on, keeping the core in. So you don't want your, you don't want your lower back, you don't want you bringing your stomach down and not working your, keeping your lower back in. So keep your core in. Right, four more. Right, take your hand, your head down to one side, and you're gonna just have your hands at your lower back or your pelvis, that's better. And then either cradle a hand or hold up the wrist, and you're gonna pulse the legs three times. You're gonna go one, two, three, squeeze them while you're doing it, and then you're gonna take the legs down and you're gonna lift up, open up the chest, and then release your head to the other side. Again, squeeze, lift, one, two, three, take it away, lift up, chest, head's going back to the other side. Again, lift up the legs, pulse for one, two, three, take it away, squeeze, open up, head to the other side. And swap wrists if you haven't already. Pulse for one, two, three. Lift, open up. One more for each side. Again, take it down. Pulse for one, two, three. Open up. Good. And on a side, last time. Pulse for one, two, three. Open up. And just release it down. Hands underneath the shoulders. Push yourself back to a rest pose, a child's pose. Walk it out. And just lift up. Walking it back. Right. From there, we have done sides. We have done, we'll do a plank. We'll come into a plank. So, on all, if you start your knees and hook your toes. And then all you need to do from there, when you set up, is lift your hips. From there, lift up the hips. From there, you're going to come down to your forearms and come up, but nice and slow. So we're not doing like we do in a normal abs class where we end up cheating. You're going to slow it down. So slow it down. Forearm. Forearm. Up. Palm. So if you slow it down, it's a lot harder. Down, down, up, up. Two more times. Down, down, up, up. One more time. Down, down, palm in, up, up. Good. Push the bum back. Walk the hands out, walk it back. Back to, we're going to go to all fours. From there, you're going to take opposite palm to opposite knee, and we're going to push to make an arch, push into the palms as much as you can, arch the back, and then you're going to round. Just round in. Same again, just arch and up. Arm round. And then back to neutral. Swap through. Opposite hand, opposite knees in the middle. And again, you're going to arch it up, sorry, first. Pull them out. And then push to round. One more of each. Arch. and then back in. Right, we're going to come back onto our back. So from there, cross the feet over, come back onto your back. So nice and controlled, slow down. Lengthen out from the legs, lengthen out from the arms. Right, from there, we are going to do a bit of, again, push-pull sort of situation. So from there, what you're going to do, you're going to lift up just one leg, and you're just going to do same hand, same arm. And you're going to lift up the chest, and you're going to push, but you're going to pull your leg in, but push your leg away. And then ease it off, back down. Come up, push, pull. So you're getting your abs working. And ease it down, so up sides. So again, we're going to do both eventually. So you will feel it both sides. Again, lift up, squeeze, ease it down. And again, lift, push, pull. Back down. One more. Lift. And ease it off. Well, right, both. So taking both legs up. Hands in. We're just going to keep our head down with the first couple. Push, pull. Ease it off. And again, push, pull. Ease it off. Right, head's going to lift. Push, pull. You're going to feel it a lot more. And ease it down. Lift up again. Push, pull. Ease it off. One more, lift up, and ease it off. Brill. Right, we're going to go into single leg, into double, with a bit of a twist. So, from here, lifting up the leg, so straight, and then we're going to swap, going up, so that's easy, easier. And then we're going to gradually take it down. And then we're going to go lower. So the lower is harder. Keep breathing. Up. Up. So this is easier. Work our way down to harder. Last four, and tuck it in, well, right, double leg, so, from there, lift up, from there, you're going to go up with the arms, tuck in, out with the arms, tuck in. I realise I've come a bit too close to the mat, to the wall, and then over and straight away tuck it in. Just try and keep going if you want to. I'm just going to shuffle this back up on the other side. So again, tuck, up, tuck, middle side, tuck, further down, away, tuck to the top, tuck, middle side, tuck, overhead, further. Right, one more time through. Up, middle, and down. Tuck in and rest. Right, we're just going to combine them two together just to finish. Right, so lifting up, just going to do normal. We're not adding the movements in. So, single leg. Good. Keep breathing. Lift up a bit more if you can. Four more. Bring them in, little release. Lift back up, double leg stretch. take it over, sweep it round, take it over, sweep it round, take it over. Two more. One more. Little rest. Right, one more time through. Lift up. Double leg. Single leg, sorry. Right, swap. 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 Right, this next one, we're going to hold it up. Pull it up. Hold. Keep it there. Pull, pull, pull. Hold. Swap. Hold. Back to single leg last time, and then we're going to double. Right, four more. One, two, three, four. Little rest. Right, double. Same again, set it up. Right, away, sweep round. Away, sweep. And again, sweep. Again. Right. Right, tuck it in. This next one we're going to hold. Ready? Away, hold. Tuck it in. Again, away, hold. Tuck it in. Right, four more. Off we go. One more. And rest. Whew. Brill. Rock side to side, feet down, just a little rock side to side for your neck, for your head, maybe for your neck each side, back to the middle and just tilt back and forwards, just kind of give yourself a double chin and then just release the neck, double that. Well, right, from there we are going to come onto the side, come up. So spin round, one leg straight, one leg bend, help you come onto your front. If you come off your mat, come back on. And then from there, palms underneath the shoulders, push the bum back to the heels. Yeah, child's pose, push it back. From there, stick your bum up in the air and just come forwards, wiggle your fingers forwards a little bit and just drop the head, stretching a bit out the back and then shuffle back. And then from there, knees together, hands by your feet, drop the head and just round, let your shoulders kind of hug your legs and just squeeze into a ball. And then just put weight into your shins to the floor, slowly bring it up, curl that back up to kneeling, just heads back up. Right, we're gonna make our way back up, palms down, English, and toes, push the body weight and feet, slowly building back up, one vertebra at a time, making sure your head's the last thing to come up. Once your head's come up, take the arms out by the sides, lengthen up. Once you're ready, drop the arms, let yourself hang down, release any tension. And same again, build it back up. Again, heads are asking to come up, breathing in as you're coming up. Extend the arms at the top. Okay, once you're ready, drop the arms, let yourself hang down. And then last one, deep breath in, build it back up. And then bring the arms up by the sides as you come up, palms together, breathe in, breathe out, bring them down to your chest, and let's see this done. Spot on. Right, hope you enjoyed that one. So just under 30 minutes, so hope you can squeeze that one in. Enjoy, see you later.